Hey everybody, welcome back to another edition of Awaken the Wonder. Right off the top, just want to remind you, subscribe, leave a rating there for those listening on the podcast. If you're watching on YouTube today, make sure you turn on the notification bell and subscribe. We'd love to make sure you're aware when there's more content. I'm excited to welcome back my dear friend and the one and only evangelist, Michael Job. Welcome back, man.
Thank you so much, bro. Thanks for having me on
today. Dude, love you, brother. This is going to be good today.
Hallelujah.
Now, we're both inspired by an evangelist friend of ours who's been a mentor, a legend, and somebody that we have both gleaned a lot from, Reinhard Bonnke. He went to be with the Lord now over a year ago, but he would always say, "You don't need to pray for the heavens to be opened, because they are already open."
Hallelujah.
You know, he's like, when they opened up for and Jesus and the dove came down, he's like, they didn't close back up. You know, that's kind of his concept there. So we know, in our friendship, Michael, you're quite the prayer warrior, quite the intercessor. I know we touched a little bit on prayer at the beginning. But you've been somebody who has moved and moves mountains through your prayer. You see healing and miracles all the time, which is incredible. But how does one keep the heavens open in their prayer? How does one continue to allow the Spirit of God having open access from heaven to earth in your life? Because you walk in this daily. It's not even just like on a crusade or an event or something. You do this daily. And I think our listeners today could really learn a lot from you on how to keep that open. So what would you say, man? How do we keep that open?
I think it's being attentive to the person of Jesus. As soon as our minds get too distracted and we're not aware of him, simple awareness of Jesus and his presence will cause our hearts to turn towards him and not only want to communicate, but listen to keys to see what he has to say. If we're constantly aware of him, he has things to say to us that'll speak into many people's lives. So I think it first has to start with our awareness of him. He said, "I'm with you always," and he truly is. So we have to open our spirits and let's have a listening ear throughout the day to be able to hear from him and then spend that time. And it doesn't have to be huge time. You can just, we prayed before the last broadcast we did. It was very short prayer, but Caleb starts going into a full vision and stuff, and he had to get out of that to like do the broadcast. And it's like, it doesn't have to be long. God can blow big visions. You just have 2 minutes. I used to do that at work. Just reconnect. Just, okay, I'm in between shows. I have this 5 minutes. So I just spend time with Jesus, listen, 5 minutes, and then I go on and I go witnessing to people or whatever. But I spend time throughout the day, see where those times are, and just spend time with Christ.
Now, a lot of people, they would say, "I connect with the Lord. I have a devotional time. I do read my Bible most of the time. I really try. I pray most days. I do my best to pray in the Spirit when I remember." Like, they're trying. I go to church. I'm consistent. I'm in a small group. That's like the average Christian life. They're going for it. But they're like, you're not just saying having devotions, are you? You're talking about something deeper, to being attentive all the time. You know, 1 Thessalonians 5:17, pray without ceasing. You know, that would always bug me because I'm like, well, I have to sleep. I have to eat. You know, how do I pray without ceasing? You know, but I've eventually kind of had a, revelation on that verse. But what is it? How do you pray without ceasing? How do you connect with the Lord even when you're at work, or even when you're cooking, or even when you're changing your kids' diapers, or how do you connect with the Lord all the time?
Well, I think it has to be attentive to him. Our eyes must be gazing on him, and even though we're doing other things, to keep and this is a thing we need to grow in, and I need to grow in it more, absolutely, to be aware of his presence throughout the day and listen to him. Some people try to do things, and now I'll get to Jesus, like you were hiding from Jesus the whole day, and here I am, Jesus, how are you? No, he's been with you the whole time, whether you realize it or not. So it's up to you to be aware of his presence and then continue to connect. You know, there was one day, this is what it was. So I was working at Holy Land Experience, and so I started my day, and I had like my hour and a half prayer, maybe even up to like two hours, praying all these like prayers, you know, that I would love praying for every family member, every pastor, evangelist that I knew, and then I got this good time in the Word, like an hour, and then I had like this worship time, and I went to work. I was like, man, it's going to be a good day. You know, there's so much is going to happen. Demons are going to get cast out. People are going to get healed. It was awesome. And by 12 o'clock noon, I'm swearing at people on the inside of my heart. I'm walking in the flesh. And I'm like, God, I don't understand. How did I get from spending way over 3 hours with you in the morning to I'm already in, people are asking me for pictures and on the inside and not outside, but this internal dialogue that we all have. I'm aggravated, I'm stressed, and I'm, how does this happen? I don't understand. You know, and I realize now, many years later, that it's not just about, oh, this is my God time in the morning, and now I try to be a nice person the rest of the day. No, we have to allow the Lord to be in every part of our lives. We have to do more time listening than just doing works for Him. We have to know Him, and as we walk throughout the day, to be attentive to His presence and pray throughout the day. You can say something to Him, and you can spend time. You got 2 minutes, listen to the Lord. You got 15, you got 30, praise the Lord. Actually, when I was at a Holy Land, oftentimes I would spend my whole lunchtime just with Jesus, you know, and I would spend time with Jesus because I needed that time. I wanted to get close to Him, you know. And that was my time with Him during my lunch break. You know, you can spend half of your lunch break at work with the Lord, and then the other half, you know, what are you going to do? How are you going to connect with the Lord throughout the day? I think it's important because just the model, oh, this is my devotional time, and now you're just living and be a nice person. No, He wants to be involved in all of your life. And we're going to end up walking in the flesh like I did that one day. Had a huge amount, and I was disgusted. I was like, I don't understand, God. I did all this. I did everything that I know, and I'm walking in the flesh. God, why did this happen? Why? Now I know a little bit more that it's listening, being aware of His presence, praying throughout the day, not just one time in the morning, regardless of how long it is. Let us live with Him.
Yeah, just think of a normal 8-hour day of work. Somebody goes to work, and you're like, you have a great start to your morning, and then you go to work, and by the time you get home, you feel like you're beat up. You feel like you got nothing left. Like, that's not the person that left the house this morning when I got back today. You know, it's like, what happened? You know,
yes.
Well, life happened to you, but mm-hmm. you turned off the Jesus part, and that's the part that got messed up, because He isn't like a switch. He isn't like a thing. He isn't some, like, set aside, He isn't just devotions or... He isn't just reading the Bible. He's engaged in every part. I never leave you. You know, I think it was a Michael Culiano sermon one time. I heard him say, you know, every time we're with Jesus at a church service or a moment or devotions, you know, do you realize we're always the ones that leave? And I'm like, to think like the last thing Jesus remembers so often is that we turned our back and walked away, you know, maybe not even in some bad way, but it's like, we're always the one that leaves that place because He doesn't leave. He's right there all the time. He's always there to engage with you. I don't know about you, but I've noticed when, because I try to operate the same way, when I'm engaging with the Lord, the heavens are open. That's kind of the theme here. It's almost as if the more I turn my attention to it and the longer I turn my attention to it, the more quantity and quality that comes out of it. It's almost like the more I engage with Him and stay aware from Him, stay aware of Him in my day, the more I continue to hear Him and see Him in everything. Even when I go to the grocery store or go check the P.O. box or I go down to the mail or I take a walk at the park or I go over and I make a phone call. Like the more I'm engaging with Him and driving, whatever it may be, It's almost like it just the pressure, the good pressure of presence just increases because He's just there and I'm sensing Him longer and the quality's getting better. I mean, I don't know if it's like this with you, but have you noticed that the more you turn your attention to Him, the more His attention seems to turn to you?
I'm growing in that, so you might be a little bit more developed than me in that. There's areas that I still need to turn my attention more to Him, but that's really my goal of one of my goals of life is to be constantly aware of his presence.